In this session, we will see about the primary rule of interpretation of statue. This is part 2. In the first part, we have already seen about the literal rule and the golden rule. In this rule, we will see about the mischief rule. This mischief rule came in 1584. This is also called the Haydn rule. The rule says it prescribes four things to do. What was the common law? At that time there were no law. It is only British was having only common law. What they say? What was the common law? What was the mischief or defect? What remedy the parliament wanted to have? What is the reasons for the remedy? These are the four things the court should see before interpreting, before applying this rule. They should see what was the law before this. Before the act is passed, what was the position? Number one. Number two, why the act was implemented, act was passed. What was the mischief to avoid, which thing the act was passed. Third, what was the remedy the act is giving now. Fourth, what is the reason? Giving you an example. In a Delhi rape case, the accused were all small boys of below 18 years. 18 years, if they are below 18 years, they cannot be convicted for an offense of rape. They will get maximum of 3 years. No serious punishment. What was the position before the law is passed? Law before the law is passed, up to 18 years, they cannot be convicted for an offense under rape. For serious punishment cannot be given, only 3 years can be given. This was the position before that. What was the mischief? Minors are using this juvenile act to do some offenses. This was the position. What the remedy the parliament wanted to have? They want to avoid these persons of 16 years to 18 years and want to give serious punishment to them. What was the true reason? True reason because this, if you give serious punishments, this type of offenses can be avoided. This is the mischief rule. What was the rule before that? Why the act has come? What the remedy they want to give, what is the purpose? This is mischief rule. If you see 2-3 cases, we will understand. Smith versus Hughes. In this case, that British was having an act called the Street Act. Prostitutes should not stand in the street for their business. They should not invite their customers standing in the street. In this case, a lady was standing in her balcony. He was not inviting, he was just making sound on the balcony door, window. The person responded was staying in 2-3 houses away from her house. However, the police filed a case under the Street Act for the prosecution. Contention was, we should not stand in the street. I am in my balcony. I am not inviting. I am making a noise only. The person is also in another house. Still, they applied the mischief rule. What was the rule? Before passing the Street Act, to avoid the prosecution, you are continuing with the same thing. You are committing the same offense. So, you are liable under the Act. There is another case in the same case, same act, DPP versus Bull. In this case, this is a male prostitute. He was booked under the act, Street Act. His contention is this act mentions only female. I am a male, so I am not coming under this act. But they applied the mischief rule. What is this? It is a prostitution. Whether male or female, the same thing. So you have committed an offense. There is another case, Elliot versus Gray. In this case, the person parked his car outside, removed the battery, removed the tires. Car was there, but the police booked for non-insurance of the vehicle. Court applied the rule. Why the insurance has come? It is to avoid injury or damage to the third party, to compensate the injury or damages to the third party. Your vehicle is also outside your house. It may also cause injury or damages to the third party. So insurance is a must. In RMD, Chambar Bagwala versus Union of India, in the Price Competition Act, this act passed for avoiding gambling, where the court held that if the activity involves the skill of the person playing, then it is not a gambling, it is not an offense under the act. This mischief rule is advocated by so many people. It has some advantages. Law commission recommends this. It avoids unjust and absurd meaning for the act, not resulting in that type of punishments also. For example, in the golden rule, we have seen two courts are giving two different judgments. It closes the loopholes. That loopholes means, in the case we have seen Smith versus Hughes, that lady, instead of standing in the street, it is sitting in the balcony. It is a loophole, but it closes the loophole. It allows the law to develop. In the next law, by an amendment, they will make, instead of street, they will make, instead of week, staying at a house also will be included. That type of developments can be done by this rule. But there are some criticisms against this. It is a very old rule. It is not applicable to the present day. It was applicable to the common law area, common law period, not for the present period. That is the first criticism. Second is, it gives discretion to the advocate, to the courts, to make law. What was not an offense earlier is made as an offense now. A male prostitution was not an offense under the act, but the court now says that it is an offense. The person might be thinking that it is not an offense I am doing, but subsequent to the case it is making, that is an offense. It was not an offense as per the act, but these people are telling, no, it is an offense, and they are making as a backdated offense. Then we will move on to the fourth one, rule of harmonious construction. Harmonious construction means when two acts or two sections does not go together, then harmonious construction is required. When there are inconsistency between two sections, or between a central act or state act, or between two acts, then the courts apply this harmonious construction, which is beneficial will be taken. It is a rule of harmonious construction. In one case, MSM Sharma versus Sri Krishna Sinha. MSM Sharma versus Sri Krishna Sinha. Article 19.1a gives a right to speech. Freedom of speech is given. But Article 194.3 gives a freedom to the speaker of the assembly. This person is a reporter. That speaker has removed some passages from the record of the assembly. This person reported that also. He has committed an offense as per Article 194.3, because he has reported something which he should not have reported. This person is saying, but Article 19.1a gives me the freedom to write, freedom to speak. Now, two things are contradictory. This person is given freedom to write, freedom to speak, but the assembly speaker is restricting his freedom of reporting a matter. Then comes the harmonious construction. The court has held that you have a right, but subject to the rights of the Assembly Speaker 194(3) overrules your right in respect of the proceedings of the Assembly. Same is the case with the Article 13(2) and 368 gives the power to amend the article, amend the constitution. Parliament can amend it, 368. But Article 13(2) says that the fundamental right cannot be altered. So two things are contradictory. In Kolhapur case, it was held that 368 gives the power to change everything except the fundamental right. By overruling the earlier decision, Kolhapur case held that 13(2), that is the fundamental right, cannot be altered. 368 can alter other things. This is called harmonious construction, which is in better way construction to affect not the other persons. When there is inconsistency, they decide which should overrule the other. In the next session, we will see some other topics.